This is an inscription at the Baikuti Hill Jain Temple at Aihole in the state of Karnataka.
Trinshatu Trishasreshu Bharatah Taha Vaditah Saptabda Satyukteshu Chateshvateshu Panchashu Panchasatshu Kalau Kale Chatshu Panchashahatsu Samasu Samatitasu Shakanabhi Bhujam.
This is an inscription at the Baikuti Hill Jain Temple at Aihole in the state of Karnataka. This is the famous Aihole inscription of Ravi Kirti at the Baikuti Temple. Ravi Kirti was a minister and a poet in the court of the Badami Chalukyan king Pulkeshin II, and it is written in Sanskrit language and the script is old Kannada script. It is considered as one of the finest pieces of extant poetry in the Sanskrit language and is a eulogy of King Pulkeshin II and his conquest. What it basically means is that 30 years plus 3000 years plus 700 years plus 5 years, that is 3735 years have passed since the Bharata war was conducted, and 50 plus 6 plus 500, that is 556 years have passed since the Saka era began. Basically, it tells us that this engraving or the inscription was made after 3735 years of the Mahabharata war, or 556 years after the starting of the Saka era. Now let us understand the words. Trin Shatasu Trishahasareshu Bharata Daha Vaditaha. That means 30 plus 3000 since the death of hero of Bharata war. This points to Krishna's death, who supervised the Mahabharata war. Verse 1 and 2. Victorious is the holy Jinendra, he who is exempt from old age, death and birth, the sea of whose knowledge the whole world is comprised like an island. And next, long victorious is the immeasurable wide ocean of the Chalukya family, which is the birthplace of jewels of men that are ornamented of the diadem of earth. Verse 3 and 4. And victorious for very long is Satyasaraya, who in bestowing gifts and honors on the brave and on the learned, both together on either, observes not the rule of the correspondency of number, and many members of that race went on conquest, applied to whom the title of favorite of the earth had at last become appropriate, had passed away. Verse number 5 and 6. There was of the Chalukya lineage the king named Jayasimha Vallabha, who in battle were horses, foot soldiers and elephants. Bewildered, fell down under the strokes of many hundreds of weapons, and where thousands of frightful headless trunks and of flashes of rays of swords were leaping to and fro, by his bravery made fortune his own, even though she is suspected of fickleness. Verse number 7 and 8. His son was he who was named Ranaraga of divine dignity, the one master of the world, whose superhuman nature, even when he was asleep, people knew from the preeminence of his form. His son was Pulkeshin, who though endowed with the moon's beauty and though the favorite of the fortune, became the bridegroom of Vatapi Puri, whose path in the pursuit of these three objects of life the kings on the earth even now are unable to follow, and bathed by whom with the waters of the purificatory rite, when he performed the horse sacrifice, the earth beamed with brightness. Verse number 9 and 10. His son was Kirtivarman, the knight of doom to the Nalas, Mauryas and Kadambas, whose mind, although his thoughts kept aloof from others' wives, was attracted by the fortune of his adversary, who having secured the fortune of victory by his valor in war, being a scent elephant of a king of great strength, at once completely broke down the multitude of the broad Kadamba trees, the Kadambas. Verse number 11 and 12. When his desire was bent on the dominion of the Lord of the Gods, his younger brother Mangalesha became king, who by the sheets of dust of his army of horses, encamped on the shores of the eastern and western seas, stretched an awning over the quarters. Who is that house which was the battlefield, took in marriage the damsel, the fortune of the Kalachuris, having scattered the gathering gloom, the array of elephants with hundreds of bright red lamps, the swords. Verse number 13 and 14. And again, when he was desirous of taking the island of Revati, his great army with many bright banners, which had ascended the ramparts as it was reflected in the waters of the sea, appeared like Varuna's forces, quickly came there at once at his word of command. When his elder brother's son, named Pulkeshin, of a dignity like Nasura was coveted by fortune and finding his uncle to be jealous of him, Thriyat had formed the resolution to wander abroad as an exile. Verse 15 and 16. That Mangalesha, whose great strength became on all sides reduced by the application of the powers of good counsel and energy gathered by him, abandoned together the effort to secure the kingdom of his own son, both that no mean kingdom of his and his life. Then on the subversion of that rule encompassed by the darkness of enemies, the whole world grew light again, invaded as it were by the lustrous rays of his irresistible splendor. For when was it that the sky ceased to be black like swarms of bees, with thundering clouds, in which flashes of lightning were dancing like banners, and the edges of which were crushed in the rushing wind? Verse 17 and 18. When, having found the opportunity, he who was named Appaika and Govinda approached with their troops of elephants to conquer the country north of the Vaimarathi, the one in battle through his armies came to know the taste of fear, while the other at once received the reward of the services rendered by him. When he was besieging Vanavasi, which for a girdle has the rows of Hamsa birds that sport on the highways of the Varada as their play places, and which by its wealth rivaled the city of the gods, the fortress on land having the surface of the earth all around covered with great sea of his army, to the looker on seemed at once converted into a fortress in the water. Verse 19 and 20. Although in former days they had acquired happiness by renouncing the seven sins, the Ganga and the Alupa lords, being subdued by his dignity, were always intoxicated by drinking the nectar of close attendance upon him. In the Konkanas, the impetuous waves of the forces directed by him speedily swept away the rising wavelets of pools, the Mauryas. Verse 21 and 22. When, radiant like the destroyer of Pura, he besieged Puri, the fortune of the western seas, with hundreds of ships in appearance like arrays of fretting elephants, the sky dark blue as a young lotus and covered with tiers of massive clouds resembled the sea, and the sea was like the sky. Subdued by his splendor, the Latas, Malavas and the Gujaras became as it were teachers of how feudataries subdued by force ought to behave. Verse 23 and 24. Harsha, whose lotus feet were arranged with the rays of the jewels of the diadems of host of feudataries, prosperous with unmeasured might, through him had his mirth melted away by fear, having became loathsome with his rows of lordly elephants fallen in battle. While he was ruling the earth with his broad armies, the neighborhood of the Vindhyas, by no means destitute of the lustre of many sandbanks of the Riva, shone even brightly by his great personal splendor, having to be avoided by his elephants, because, as it seemed, they by their bulk rivaled the mountains. Verse 25 and 26. Almost equal to Indra, he by means of all three powers, gathered by him according to the rule, by his noble birth and other excellent qualities, acquired his sovereignty over the three Maharashtras with their 9,000 villages. Through the excellencies of their householders, prominent in the pursuit of three objects of life, and having broken the pride of other rulers of the earth, the Kalingas with the Koslas by his army were made to evince sign of fear. Verse 27-28. Hard pressed by him, Pishtapura became a fortress not difficult to of access, wonderful, the ways of the Kali age to him were inaccessible. Ravaged by him, the waters of Kunala, colored with the blood of the men killed with many weapons, the land within it overspread with arrays of accoutred elephants, was like the cloud-covered sky in which the red evening twilight had arisen. Verse 29-30. With their sixfold forces, the hereditary troops and the rest, who raised spotless chowries, hundreds of flags, umbrellas, and the darkness, who churned the enemies elated with the sentiments of heroism and energy. He caused the splendor of the Lord of the Pallavas, who had opposed the rise of his power, to be obscured by the dust of his army and to vanish behind the walls of Kachipura. When straightway he strove to conquer the Cholas, the Kaveri, who has the darting carps for her tremulous eyes, had her current obstructed by the causeway formed by his elephants, whose rutting juice was dripping down and avoided the contact with the ocean. Verse 31 and 32. There he caused great prosperity to the Cholas, Keralas and Pandyas, he being the hot red sun to the poor frost, the army of the Pallavas. While he, Satyasraya, endowed with the power of the energy, mastery and good counsel, having conquered all the quarters, having dismissed the kings full of honors, having done homage to gods and Brahmins, having entered the city of Vatapi, is ruling like one city, this earth which has the dark blue waters of the surging seas for its home. Verse 33-34. When 30 and 3,005 years besides, joined with the 700 years have passed since the Bharata War, and when 50 and 6 and 500 years of the Saka kings also have gone in the Kali age. Verse 35-37. The stone mention of Jinendra, a mention of every kind of greatness, has been caused to be built by the wise Ravikirti, who has obtained the highest favors of that Satyasaraya, whose rule is bounded by the three oceans. Of this eulogy and of this dwelling of Jina, revered in the three worlds, wise Ravikirti himself is the author and also the founder. May that Ravikirti be victorious, who full of discernment has used the abode of Jina, firmly built of stone, for a new treatment of his theme, and who, thus wise poetic skills, has attained to the fame of Kalidasa and of Bhairavi. The Ailo inscription, with its different published translations, has been a source of Deccan and Indian history in the 6th and the 7th century. It is also a source of controversies and inconsistencies, and the claims in the Ailo inscriptions are compared to the inscriptions found outside of Badami Chalukyan kingdom.